what I'm holding in my hand is the original output platen cover for the Latex 360 and 370. Now, these shipped with the 360 and 370. So if you have a 360 or 370, you probably have a set of these. I want to explain what they were for. I want to explain what they were not for. And then I want to introduce a new product that is available for you, which may solve some issues that you're encountering. Now, if you have a 330 or a 310, I'm sorry, you probably do not have these, but if you have a 330, you can always order a set. So get with your reseller and ask for the Banner Platen output covers. Now, this is the old version. What this was for is you have all the felt on one side here, and then you have these little plastic tabs, and there are two of these. These are designed to slide into a little rail right at the very edge of the platen, and then they cover the aluminum output platen. They do this primarily for fabric applications. That's what they were designed to do. When you run, say, a roll of, Fisher Tripoplin. Well, Fisher Tripoplin is a certified media, but it's going to use about 200 to 230% ink density. So you're going to be using a lot of ink. And if you run a whole roll or even a half a roll of that stuff, you're going to run so much ink and it's going to create condensation. You know, these are water-based printers. Well, you're not printing 100% anymore, you're printing 200%. So that's a lot of ink and it has to evaporate all of that water. Well, with you running a lot of fabric, very heavy coverage, you're going to create some degree of condensation. These felt covers were designed to load onto the platen cover. Now, you have to use the take-up reel when you're running fabric across this. And then it would capture that condensation so it couldn't get onto the platen and then possibly slide down the platen and drip on the fabric. That's what these condensation covers were for. They were not designed to run, say, double-sided banner. So if you are using these with the plastic tabs to print double-sided banner, stop doing that. What's going to happen is it's going to finish side A, and you're going to load it onto side B, and it's going to print the job and then try to roll backwards, and it's going to drag this thing right back into the print path, and then the print head is going to run into this. That is not good. These were not designed for that. But we have a rescue. We have a solution now, and a very elegant solution. So this that I just showed you, that is technically obsolete, okay? This is new. This replaces that. Now, if you're not having any issues and you're not running double-sided banner, those are fine. They work great for fabric. That's what they were designed for. But if you're running some double-sided banner, and then after you've printed side A, you load the banner into the machine, and the side A, which has the inked side, it's already been printed, is now going across the aluminum output platen, and it sticks a little bit. The printer is still feeding the banner, and the banner is sticking a little bit on that platen, and when that happens, it folds a little bit in the print path, and it can cause a head strike. So what we designed is a new Banner Platen output cover. This is specifically designed for banner, but as you can see with this felt there, it also works for the fabric. So it's sort of an all-in-one cover now. This has the metal rail. It's a metal L-bar. This slides into that slot instead of the plastic tabs. It's much stronger and it holds into that slot a lot better. It also comes with Velcro, okay? One piece of the Velcro goes underneath the banner platen cover, or the output platen, and then the other part attaches down across the platen. It kind of stretches down and then secures against the other Velcro, which is stuck to the underside. That allows it to be nice and tight right across there. It can't get out of that channel. It can't be pulled backward or forward. This works beautifully for double-sided banner. It also works for the condensation on heavy fabric coverage. And you can use it on some banners that even single-sided, when they go through the print path, they try to stick a little bit. Some real soft banners can do that. So if you're having trouble where the banner seems to be resisting or touching that aluminum output platen cover, call HP support and ask for the Banner Platen output covers. They're new. They will send you a set. If you have a recent 360 or 370, these will come with the printer. And then you'll say, what are these strange things? There's an instruction sheet that comes with it. It's very clear how to put them in. And then here I'm going to show you the way that I like to insert them. It's very simple. And I use them for a few other things too. Occasionally some magnetics. Any material that I think is going to try to stick on that platen, I'll put these on. And that's still a fairly small, very small group of materials. But if I do think it's going to stick a little on that warm aluminum platen, I'll use these. And they're very handy and they're easy to put on. The Velcro that you stick on the underside stays there permanently. And there are two of them. Again, just call 1-800-HP-SUPPORT and ask for your set if you feel you need them. If you don't run a lot of double-sided, don't worry about it.